Hello everyone, I welcome you all in this session. So in today's session we are going to have a discussion on Rankine cycle. So in previous lecture I have already told you that there are two types of power plant. One is thermal power plant and another one is hydroelectric power plant. Then the thermal power plant is again can be subdivided into two types. One is gas cycle thermal power plant or vapor cycle thermal power plant. Okay, so in gas cycle thermal power plant the working fluid is gas, but in vapor cycle thermal power plant or steam thermal power plant the working fluid is steam. Okay, so gas cycle thermal power plant works on the Brayton cycle, whereas the steam power plant or vapor cycle thermal power plant works on the Rankine cycle. Okay, so we can say that Rankine cycle is the practical working cycle in steam thermal power plant. Okay, so it is practical working cycle in steam thermal power plant, steam or vapor power plant. Okay, so Rankine cycle consists of four process two of them are constant pressure process and two of them are isentropic process, means entropy constant. Okay, so let me draw the TS diagram first. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is pressure P is equal to P1. This is pressure P is equal to P2. So from here we can see that process 1 to 2 constant entropy or isentropic compression. Okay, or isentropic compression in pump. Then process 2 to 3 it is a heat addition, and process 3 to 4 it is isentropic expansion in turbine, and 4 to 1 is again constant pressure heat rejection. Okay, so we already know that these are the constant pressure lines, these two we have already studied the TS diagram, so we know that constant pressure line on TS diagram are like that. Okay, and constant entropy lines are vertical lines. So this is the schematic diagram of a steam thermal power plant. We have process 1 to 2, one pump. Okay, so here reversible adiabatic compression is going on. Then again process 2 to 3 we have boiler, so in boiler the heat addition is going on. Then 3 to 4 turbine, reversible adiabatic expansion in turbine. Then 4 to 1 constant pressure heat rejection in condenser. Okay, so we can write process 1 to 2. 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic compression of, see, we are doing compression from this state and this is the saturated liquid state. Okay, so compression of liquid from condenser pressure to boiler pressure. You can see here कंडेंसर प्रेशर इज दिस पी टू एंड बॉयलर प्रेशर इज दिस पी वन. ओके सो दिस इज लोअर प्रेशर, दिस इज हायर प्रेशर. सो वी आर कंप्रेसिंग द लिक्विड फ्रॉम लोअर प्रेशर टू हायर प्रेशर इन द पंप. ओके देन अगेन वी कैन सी इन द पंप. देन प्रोसेस 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3, we can easily see that it is constant pressure process. So constant pressure heat addition to convert liquid into superheated steam. Sometimes superheated or saturated steam in the boiler. Okay, so what we are doing from 2 to 3, at point 2, we know that it is the subcooled liquid because it's left side region. Okay, so from 2 we are continuously adding heat and we are changing the state of the water. At 2 it is in subcooled liquid, then at this point it is saturated water, then again at this point it is saturated vapor, then again it is superheated vapor. Okay, so this whole process is going on into the boiler. Then process 3 to 4, it's again reversible adiabatic. Expansion in turbine from boiler pressure to condenser pressure. Okay. Then process 4 to 1, and again constant pressure heat rejection in the condenser. Okay, so now we know what are the different processes involving the Rankine cycle. Okay, so we have drawn the TS diagram. Now we can draw the PV diagram of the Rankine cycle with the help of TS diagram. Okay, so again let me draw the PV diagram. Pressure, volume, and again dome will be there because we are dealing here two phase region. Okay, so process 1 to 2, process 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic compression. Okay, so volume, since the compression is going on, so pressure will increase and the volume will decrease, but we know that at one point it is liquid and liquid is almost incompressible. Okay, so as we increase the pressure, the volume remains almost constant. Okay, there is very very little decrease in volume as we increase the pressure. So it goes this like this, 1 2, then again 2 to 3, constant pressure heat addition. So we can see in previous diagram that heat addition, the subcooled liquid is going converted into superheated. So again here it is subcooled, I am adding the heat at constant pressure, then superheated. Okay, so this is the heat addition process 2 to 3. Then again reversible adiabatic expansion. So now we can see that here it is superheated vapor. Okay, so when we expand it, it will convert into saturated vapor. Okay, so the volume of the liquid, the vapor will increase. Okay, so it will go towards rightwards. And then again, constant pressure heat rejection. Four. So this is the PV diagram of Rankine cycle. Okay, so now we can easily find out that what will be the net work done. W net, it will be equal to W turbine minus W pump. Okay, why? Because in turbine we are getting the work in expansion, but in pump we have to input the work. Okay, but as opposed to the Brayton cycle, where we used the compressor for compressing the air from low condenser pressure to combustion or high pressure, we are using pump. Okay, in compressor the working fluid is air, so that's the volume of the working volume is very high, but in pump the working fluid is liquid, so whose volume is very less. We can see here the volume of the liquid is very less, okay, as compared to the saturated vapor or superheated vapor. Okay, so we know that control system work is equal to integration VTP. This is also called open system work, flow or flow work. Okay, so it is dependent on volume. Okay, so at point one the volume is very less, so work done or work required to run the pump will be also less. Okay, so the W pump will be very less in comparison to WT, means pump work will be very less in comparison to turbine work. Okay, so now we can find out the pump work and turbine work. For process 1 to 2, from SFE we can easily write m dot H1 C1 square by 2 plus G Z1 plus Q dot is equal to m dot H2 C2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus W dot CV. Okay, so now we know that it's reversible adiabatic, so it's zero. Change in kinetic energy and potential energy are neglected. So from here what we will have m dot H1 is equal to m dot H2. Now work is done on the system, because in pump we are doing the work on the system, so WCV will negative sign WP. So from here WP will be m dot H2 minus H1. Okay, then again process 2 to 3. In process 2 to 3 we can see it is the heat addition in the boiler, so there is no work output, the control work. So and again the change in kinetic energy and potential energy are neglected, so here it will come m dot H1 plus Q dot plus m dot H2. Okay, because W control volume is zero for process 2 to 3, because we are not getting any work. Okay, but heat addition is there, so QA is equal to, so heat addition will be the with the positive sign. So m dot, sorry, it is 2 to 3, m dot H3 minus H2. One thing let me remind you, that we cannot write here change in enthalpy or difference of enthalpy equal to Cp delta T, because we are not dealing with air or ideal gas, okay? Two, three, then 3 to 4. Again, for 3 to 4, it's again reversible adiabatic expansion. So Q will be 0. Change in kinetic energy and potential energy will be 0. Neglected. So m dot h3 is equal to m dot h4. Now work is being done by the system, so it will be positive W turbine. Okay. So from here W turbine is equal to m dot h3 minus h4. Then again last 4 to 1, you can easily find out that Q rejected QR is equal to m dot h4 minus h1. This you can easily find out. Okay, so now what will be the efficiency of the turbine? So efficiency of the turbine will be, sorry, efficiency of the Rankine cycle will be W net over QA. W net is equal to W turbine minus W pump over QA. Okay, so by putting the turbine work and pump work and divided it by heat addition, we can find out the Rankine efficiency. One last thing what I want to tell you, that we have already discussed that control volume work is negative integration V dP. Okay, so when I am applying this in process 1 to 2, so what will be WCV is equal to minus integration 1 to 2 V dP. Okay, we have all seen here that for process 1 to 2 the change in volume is almost constant. Okay, variation of volume with respect to the pressure is almost constant. Okay, so we can take volume outside. So from here we can get V integration dP 1 to 2. Okay, so what we'll get? V P2 minus P1. Okay, so pressure at point 2 minus pressure at point 1. Okay, so this is coming with negative sign because we are doing the work on the system. So we can tell W control volume is equal to V1 P2 minus P1, and it is also equal to H2 minus H1. Okay, then next is specific steam consumption or steam rate. It is the ratio of steam flow rate to the power output. Okay, so steam flow rate is in kg per second and power output is in kilowatt. Okay, we know that power output is m dot w net so from here we get specific steam consumption is equal to 1 by W net. Okay, it will come kg per second divided by kilowatt. Okay, now if I want to change this second into hour, then it will come specific steam consumption is equal to 3600 by W net kg per kilowatt hour. ओके, लास्ट इज हीट रेट। हीट रेट इज द रेशियो ऑफ हीट इनपुट टू द पावर आउटपुट। So we know heat input is equal to m dot s into q supplied or q added divided by m dot s divided by w net. Okay, this we can cancel out. So, and we know that w net by q addition is equal to heat supplied. So heat rate is equal to 1 by thermal efficiency. Okay, so now we'll do a basic numerical based on this. The values of enthalpy of steam at inlet and outlet of a steam turbine is in a Rankine cycle are 3200 kilojoule per kg and 1800 kilojoule per kg, okay, respectively. If the pump work is 200 kilojoule per kg, find specific steam consumption in kilo kg per kilowatt hour. So we have given the pump work WP is equal to 200 kg per kilojoule per kg, and we have not given the turbine work, but instead of turbine work we have given the value of enthalpy of steam at inlet and outlet of the steam turbine. Okay, so we can see that at inlet enthalpy is H3 and at outlet enthalpy is H4, and we have already found out the work output of the turbine is equal to m dot H3 minus H4. So if we are not putting the value of m dot, then we are taking it per unit mass. Okay, so we can write WH3 is equal to given 3200 kilojoule per kg and H4 is equal to 1800 kilojoule per kg. So W turbine will be equal to H3 minus H4. Okay, so it will come 1400 kilojoule per kg. Okay, and we know that specific steam consumption is equal to m dot s over power, and again power is equal to m dot s over power is equal to m dot w net. Okay, m dot cancel, it will come kg per second divided by kilowatt, and again we have to find out in kilowatt hours. So converting second into R, it will come 3600 divided by W net kg per kilowatt hour. Okay, so we have turbine work, we have pump work, we can find out easily. W net will be W turbine minus W pump, so 1400 minus 200, because W pump is work done on the system, so it will come with negative sign. So, okay, so 1400 minus 200, it will come 1200 kilojoule per kg. Okay, so specific steam consumption is equal to 3600 by 1200, so 3 kg per kilowatt hour. Okay, so this is the basic numerical. We will do a number of numerical problem based on Rankine cycle. So now we will discuss about the applicability of Carnot cycle in steam thermal power plant. We have already told that in the working cycle for the steam thermal power plant is Rankine cycle, but why we cannot use the Carnot cycle in steam thermal power plant. Okay, so for that I have drawn the TS diagram of Rankine cycle, and again here I have shown the TS diagram of Carnot cycle that we already know. Okay, so now if we want to use the Carnot cycle in thermal power plant, okay, so we will try to draw the Carnot cycle in this TS diagram. Okay, so there are number of possibilities through which we can draw the Carnot cycle. Okay, so let me just draw. Okay, this one, then again this one, one is this one. Okay, let me rename it 1 dash, this is 2 dash, this is 2 double dash, 3 dash, 3 double dash, this one is 4 and this one is 4 dash. Okay, so we can see there are number of possibilities of the Carnot cycle. Okay, what are these? One is 1 dash to 2 dash, then 3 dash, 3 dash to 4 dash, and 4 dash to 1. This is one possibility. Then again 1 to 2 double dash, 2 double dash to 3 dash, 3 dash to 4 dash. This is another possibility. Then again 1 to 2 double dash, 2 double dash to 3 double dash, 3 double dash to 4, and 4 to 1. This is again another possibility. Okay, so we have number of possibilities of Carnot cycle, but let us go with details by one by one. Okay, so first we will consider cycle 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, and 4 dash. Okay, this one. Okay, so there are a number of points. I will not write down all here, but I will just tell you what are the difficulties while we use this cycle in thermal power plant. Okay, so here you can see that as we are expanding the steam in turbine, at the outlet of turbine or in the turbine itself, the steam is being converted into liquid. Okay, it is going into wet region, so there will be some saturated liquid vapors and there will be a mixture of saturated vapor and saturated liquid. Okay, so due to the moisture content, the blades of the turbine will get corrode. Okay, because at 4 point there is a moisture content, because here the region is, the steam is in wet region, so there will be saturated vapor and saturated liquid, mixture of saturated vapor and saturated liquid will be there. So moisture content will be there. So due to the moisture, the corrosion of steam blade will take place. Okay, so one problem is corrosion. Then again, if we want to compress from point 1 dash, we have to stop the condensation at point 1. Okay, so it is very difficult, because it is very difficult to stop a condensation at this in between somewhere, the saturated vapor and saturated liquid region. Why? Because we cannot measure exact, there are so many dryness fraction line. Okay, that we know. Let us consider this is x is equal to somewhat 0.4 or 0.4, let us consider. Okay, so it is very difficult to measure at which time or how much, at which time it will be reach the fraction dryness fraction at 0.4. okay, one thing is that, then another is, we don't have the, at this point we have the mixture of saturated vapor and saturated liquid. Okay, and we don't have a pump which can compress both liquid and vapor. Okay, for vapor we have compressor, for liquid we have pump, but we don't have any device which can convert a mixture of liquid and vapor. Okay, and even if it is possible, let us assume that it is possible, but still the volume at this point is very high. Okay, so we know that pump work is VDP. Okay, so VDP, if we apply the formula, the volume is high, so pump work will be high, so most amount of turbine expansion work will get consumed into pump work. Okay, so this cycle we cannot assume. Then again possibility 1 dash, 2 double dash, 3 dash, and 4 dash. Okay, next one. So again 4 dash is again the problem of moisture content will come. And again, we are 1 to 2 double dash. We are compressing the liquid in pump. Okay, but we can see that if we draw the constant pressure line, it will go like that. So earlier in Rankine cycle, we are compressing from this pressure to this pressure. Okay, but in case of Carnot cycle, the pressure has increased from 1 to 2 double dash, but earlier it was 1 to 2. So as the pressure is increasing, so pump work will be again high. Okay, then another thing we can see, we are going this side, this towards right, from 2 double dash to 3 dash. Okay, so you can see that this 2 double dash to 3 dash is heat addition process. Okay, but as we are moving from 2 double dash to 2 dash, the pressure is decreasing. You can see another pressure line will come like this. So pressure of this line will be higher than this line. So as we are going towards the 2 dash, pressure is increasing. We are adding heat at constant temperature and pressure is increasing. Pressure is constant or decreasing, which is not possible. Okay, so this process cannot take place. Okay, then again, if you will take 1, 2 double dash, 3 double dash and 4. Okay, so again, 1 or 2 double dash, the higher pump work will be the problem. And from 3 to 3 double dash, again we are adding the heat, but the pressure is decreasing, because at this point pressure line will be something like this. So this pressure will be higher and this pressure will be lower. Okay, so again we are adding heat at constant temperature, but pressure is decreasing. Okay, so this is again not possible. Okay, so let me summarize all the different problems. Because of that, we cannot practically apply the Carnot cycle in steam power plant. Okay, so first one is problem of blade erosion, or we can say turbine blade erosion. Corrosion. Okay, will be high at lower stage of turbine. Turbine expansion, that we can see in process 3 dash to 4 dash. Okay, as we are expanding the steam in 3 dash to 4 dash, the corrosion problem will increase in steam blade turbine. Again, second one, it is not possible to control condensation process in such a manner to get desired Trenis fraction or quality of steam. Okay, so which we can see at process 4 dash to 1 dash. Okay, at 1 dash, state 1 dash, we have to stop the condensation at this point itself. So it is very difficult, or it is in a way impossible, to stop the condensation at this point perfectly. Okay, then again, third, it is not possible to design a pump which can handle both liquid and vapor phase.
together. Or we can see that it is very difficult, it is not possible to design a pump which can compress the mixture of liquid and vapor phase. Then that we can see in process 1-2, 2-, then again fourth, pump work will be very high. Okay, for Carnot cycle. Okay, pump work will be very high. We have already seen from process 1-2. Okay, that pump work is very high because of increase in pressure difference. Then last one is, it is not possible to add heat at constant temperature, but with decreasing pressure. Okay, this is happening in 2-2 and 3-3. Okay, so these are the five main points or main problems, drawbacks, so that we cannot use the Carnot cycle in steam power plant. Once again, first one is the blade erosion problem will be there. Second one, how to stop the condensation process at that perfect point or perfect quality of steam. Then again, how to compress the mixture of water vapor and saturated water. Then for this process, the pump work will be very high. And last one is, it is impossible to add heat at constant pressure and still with the decreasing pressure. Okay, so now we know why the Carnot cycle is not practically viable in steam thermal power plant. Okay, if we compare the steam thermal power plant and gas thermal power plant, okay, the efficiency of steam thermal power plant is always higher. Why? The main reason for that is less pump work in Rankine cycle. Okay, this is the main reason why the efficiency of Rankine cycle or efficiency of steam thermal power plant is higher as compared to gas power plant. Why? Because we know that W net in Rankine cycle is equal to W turbine minus W pump, and W net in Brayton cycle is W turbine minus W compressor. Okay, here we are dealing with liquid as working fluid. In compressor we are dealing with gas as working fluid. Okay, I have already told you that control volume work or open system work is integration V dp. Okay, so in case of pump it will be WL. So WP, I can write WP is equal to minus integration V liquid or F V fluid dp. And in case of compressor it will be integration V gas dp. And we know from the pure substance we have seen the number of phase diagram that Vf is very very less than Vg. So because the specific volume of liquid is very very less than the specific volume of gases, so pump work will be negligible as in comparison to the compressor work. Okay, so in Rankine cycle net work is very high as compared to the Brayton cycle. That's why the efficiency of the Rankine cycle is higher or efficiency of a steam thermal power plant is higher as compared to gas power plant or Brayton cycle. Okay.
So now we'll see what are the factors that affect the efficiency of a Rankine cycle. Okay, so from Carnot cycle we know that efficiency is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, or we can see 1 minus T2 is temperature of heat rejection and T1 is temperature of heat addition. Okay, so efficiency is a function of heat rejection and heat addition. Okay, so if we'll reduce the temperature of heat rejection, okay, so efficiency will increase, and similarly if we'll increase the temperature of heat addition, the efficiency will again increase. Okay, so by reducing the temperature heat rejection temperature and by increasing the heat addition temperature, we can increase the efficiency of the cycle. Okay, so now, but in case of Rankine cycle we can see that in Carnot cycle the heat is being added at constant temperature. Okay, but in Rankine cycle it is not that case. From here 0.2 to 0.3 heat is being added, and that 0.2 to 2 dash temperature is very changing, then again point 3 to 3 temperature is changing. Okay, so for that we assume a mean temperature. We take the mean of temperature from there 2 to 3, and we assume that we are adding the heat at mean temperature from 2 to 3. Similarly, and heat rejection 4 to 1. If the temperature is constant, then we can take that heat is rejected at this temperature only. If the temperature is varying, then again we can take the mean temperature of heat rejection. Okay, so we know that if we increase the mean temperature of heat addition, the efficiency will decrease. Efficiency will increase. Okay, let me tell you once again. We just now saw efficiency is equal to 1 minus TR over TA. So if we increase the mean temperature of heat addition, efficiency will increase. And again, if we decrease the mean temperature of heat rejection, the efficiency will increase. Okay. So now first factor that we'll consider is what will happen the efficiency with the efficiency when we decrease the condenser pressure. Okay. So I have drawn a Rankine cycle. The blue one is the previous one, this is the condenser pressure. Now I have reduced the condenser pressure to this pressure. Okay, we can see that this pressure is higher than this pressure. Okay, so what are the effects? We can easily see the earlier the expansion process was up to 0.4. So 0.4 is the saturated vapor region, but now the condensation process is up to expansion process is up to 0.4 dash. At 0.4 dash it is in wet region, so there will be the mixture of water, saturated vapor and saturated liquid, so corrosion problem will be there. So what is quality of steam is decreasing, one point. But we can see as the work expansion limits are increasing. Okay, so turbine work will increase. Okay, pump work WP. Regarding pump work we cannot say, because the pressure ratio is still the same, but the volume, what is the variation in the volume at 0.1 to 1 dash. Okay, so without knowing that we cannot tell that what is the variation in pump work, so cannot say. Okay, then again QS, Q supplied or Q added. Earlier we were adding the heat from 2 to 3. Now we are adding heat from 2 dash to 3. So heat supplied is increasing. Okay, so W net will increase.
because the W pump is almost constant, it will not change. Okay, so from here we can see that mean temperature of heat addition, see earlier we were heading we were adding the heat from T2 to T3, means this. So mean, now we are adding the heat from 2' to 3'. So in mean temperature of heat addition for process 2 to 3 will be higher than the mean temperature of heat addition for process 2' to 3, that you can easily see, because mean temperature for 2 to 3 will be somewhere this, and for 2' to 3 will be somewhere below this. Okay, so mean temperature of heat addition is decreasing. Now mean temperature of heat rejection, see earlier we were rejecting heat at this temperature, now we are rejecting heat at this temperature, so it is reducing drastically. Okay, so what will be the effect of this? Eta will increase, or thermal efficiency will increase. Why? Because mean temperature of heat rejection is decreasing drastically, and on the other hand mean temperature of heat rejection is increasing, so both will efforts that towards the increasing the efficiency. Okay, then again next factor, by increasing the boiler pressure. Okay, so let me again draw the TS diagram. So now I have drawn the plot of Rankine cycle. The previous one was 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we have increased the boiler pressure. Okay, so now we are compressing it from 1 to 2 dash. So this is the increased boiler pressure. So, and 3 to 2 dash is again expansion. Okay. So from here, we can see that as we are increasing the boiler pressure, the turbine work is increasing. Okay. And again, pump work is also increasing. Why? Because earlier we were compressing it from pressure P1 to P2. Now we are increasing the from pressure P1 to P2 dash. Okay, so difference of pressure is higher, so work will be higher. Okay, but the increase in turbine work is higher as compared to the increase in pump work, because this here the volume is higher. Okay, the specific volume of the steam is higher, so there will be W net, increase in the W net. Okay, then quality of steam at the exit of turbine is again decreasing, because earlier expansion was at this point, now expansion is at this point. Okay, QR, heat rejection, is decreasing. Earlier rejection was from 4 to 1, now rejection is from 4' to 1'. Okay, then mean temperature of heat addition, see earlier heat addition was from 2 to 3, now 2' to 3'. So mean temperature of heat addition is increasing. Mean temperature of heat rejection, it is constant because there is no change. Okay, so efficiency of the cycle will again increase. Okay, because it is constant and it is increasing, so we know efficiency is 1 minus T mean temperature of heat rejection upon mean temperature of heat addition. So this is constant and this is increasing, so efficiency will increase. Okay, then last one, by superheating. Okay.
dash. Okay, so let me tell you, whatever plot I have shown you in rank with respect to Rankine cycle, I have taken this heat addition process in superheated zone, but it is not the necessary condition. Okay, we can stop heat addition till this region, or we can heat it up to the superheated region. So it depends depends upon the requirement. Okay, so we are considering what will be the effect, or what will be the effect on efficiency from if we are heating it up to saturated vapor condition, or we are heating up to superheated vapor conditions. Okay, so in cycle 1, 2, 3, 4, we are just adding heat to convert the liquid to up to saturated vapor. But in cycle 1, 2, 3 dash and 4 dash, we are adding heat up to superheated region, or we are converting the liquid into superheated vapor. So that's why this portion is called superheating. So by superheating, what will be the effect on efficiency? Okay, so we can see from here that W turbine increasing, because the expansion is the enthalpy will obviously enthalpy at this point will be higher than the enthalpy at this point, because here superheating will is done. Okay, W pump, there is no change. Okay, process is same, what to do for both. So W net will increase. Again, Q addition, your Q supplied is increasing, because earlier we were adding heat was from 2 to 3 only. Now we are adding heat from 2 to 3 dash, because some heat is being utilized for superheating the steam. Okay, so that's why Q supplied is increasing. Q rejection, in original cycle from 3 to 4 to 1 heat is being rejected, but now from 4 dash to 1 heat is being rejected, so heat rejection is also increasing. Okay, now mean temperature of heat addition, you can easily see that mean temperature of heat addition is increasing and mean temperature of heat rejection is constant. Okay, and last, quality of the steam is increasing, so efficiency will increase. Okay, so we can see by just superheating the steam, we are getting number of benefits. First one is dryness fraction. Okay, we can have a dryness fraction with higher values. Okay, so there will be no problem with related to the corrosion of the turbine blade. Again, efficiency of the cycle is increasing. Again, turbine work is also increasing. Okay, so just by superheating the steam, we are getting number of benefits. Okay, so now we have completed the different factors, the effect of different factors on the efficiency. So in next lecture, we will go through the reheat cycle or regeneration. Okay, bye. Good.